Hey everybody, it's your girl SJ here, and I am going to be casting my right hand today. Yesterday, I did a bit of a video about how I made this hand, and this hand is so beautiful and realistic to me. And so also, I didn't think it was gonna come out this awesome, but it did. And so now, I'm gonna go ahead and do my right hand. As you can see, I gave her a nail plate, but I didn't capture that on video yesterday because number one, I didn't want to be on video screwing it up. I know everybody, you know, we're all transparent and hey, let them see your screw ups and everything. I wasn't finna do that. So, but I'll record how I actually create the nail beds for her. And yeah, so let's get started. I'm excited to have my own pair of hands because I will not be paying red iguana or black salamanders or whomever it is for a pair of hands. So the first thing, especially somebody else's hands, I thought about that. You know, when you're paying them for somebody else's hands, you know? So here go the thing, here we go. So we need 4 cups. Of tepid cold water. So I have a 4 cup, I'm sorry, we need 8 cups, and I have a 4 cup measuring utensil. So 8 cups of cold water is our first step. I'm not gonna cut out any of the steps because if I can get measuring cup, and then on the inside it has all the other measuring cups and stuff. And then so when you're finished with it, bam, that's it. Bam, put it away. So that's it for our water. Now the alternate that I am using is called Perfect Mold. Perfect Mold, and you can see it right here. I got it off of Amazon. Okay, Perfect Mold refills, got it. So according to my instructions, I pre-measured it out into this bag right here because that bag is huge. That's like a refill bag. And so 6.5 to 6.6 cups of the alginate is what you need. Now, here is what we need to know. First of all, we need to go on ahead and get this in the water and get it mixing because this stuff will start to be hard exactly 3 minutes after it hits the water, okay? So, need to hurry up. Go on ahead and get your alginate in there, and I'm using a whisk. And so, now we stir. And we're stirring. You can see dust flying and stuff, but we're stirring, making sure we get all of that nice and wet. I want to get all the lumps out. Small lumps are okay, but big lumps, like you wouldn't pour it into your container like this. Make sure that all of the powder wet. I am being cognizant of the time. When you're stirring, it feels like forever is going by. That 3 minutes from the time it hits this water, it starts to hurt. So we've got some time. We need to just make sure that it's nice. Well, I don't mean to say we've got some time. We've got a whole lot of time. Make sure we get any big clumps out. See these small clumps? They're fine. No big clumps. Into our actual container, because that's not what I'm gonna cast in. Pour into my casting container. Do not do what I did and attempt to go clean this pot out. Just put that pot onto the side. You're gonna go ahead and tap this a bit to get all the air bubbles out. See those air bubbles coming to the top? That's what you want. You don't got a lot of time to do this stuff. About 20 seconds. Happening, getting the air bubbles out. I don't see no more. So I'm gonna dunk my hand in all the way, nice coating, dip it on back up, and now I'm gonna put it in again. And now this is the time for you. Remember, I said you need to come from the side. So now this is the time for you to think about your hand position. I'm making sure that all of my fingers are very relaxed, including my thumb, because y'all saw my thumb before. And now I'm just still, so now I've adjusted my thumb on the inside. Like I said, you don't have a whole lot of time to do the adjustment. So I'm adjusting my fingers, just relaxing. And now you got a hold still. So I'm not gonna have y'all sit here while this part goes. I'm gonna go ahead and we'll come back when it's time for me to the, well, actually, no. We're just gonna stay here because I want you to, I was gonna turn it off and come back when it's time to demold it, but So you can see how long. It's gonna take about 5 minutes. Make sure you're not touching any sides or anything. Yeah, I am gonna come back. We'll be back. All right, guys, and so here we go. It's been about 5 minutes, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take my hand out, and you would think now it feels nice and firm, and it feels like it would be easy to get my hand out, but it's not. The immediate suction as soon as I start pulling, okay? And so right now, I'm just kinda wiggling my hand. Is it, there's an immediate suction that happens when I pull, but I'm just being very gentle, but coming on up. All right. Hopefully, I'm thinking that with this finger, I hit the side of the bucket. I'm hoping that I didn't. We're gonna see. Like, I got all this damn room over here and I'm in a bucket, but the rest of the mold looks beautiful on the inside. I don't know. Let me see if I can adjust it to where you guys can see on the inside. Like, this beard looks really detailed down there, like a tunnel, really detailed cavern. Okay, so now I'm gonna put this to the side just for a second, because we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna mix my silicone. So here's my part A, and here's my part B. This whole thing makes a pair of hands, okay? So I used the other half yesterday, so wonderful for me. I don't even have to measure at this point because I did it yesterday. So I'm gonna use all of my contents, all the contents of part A.
Make sure there's nothing in it.
All contents of part A go in here. I'm gonna mix my color in here too. This is where I'm gonna mix my color up at. Reason is because it's a two-part compound. You mix A and B together, and then the plasticizing starts. It starts to harden. So go ahead, get A together. I can dispose of this bottle. Now, I have my box of silicone pigment. Using brown and yellow. If you don't have brown and yellow to use to, you know, mix together, you're gonna use all the primary colors, red, blue, yellow. You mix together red, blue, yellow, and you're gonna get brown. And you can't hear me, but I had to come get a mixing stick because I thought I had it, but I didn't. So just in case you didn't hear me, like I said, I am mixing brown with some variations of yellow. If you do not have brown in your colors, in order to make brown or get this flesh tone, you're going to just mix your primary colors, which is your red, your yellow, and your blue. Mixing all of those colors together will get you a brown, and then you add in reds and yellows according to the hue that you want. You know, you want a red bone chick, give a little bit more red. You want a high yellow heifer, a little bit more yellow. But that's how it goes. I'm a high yellow chick, so I ain't even got no red out. But do you see? Mix it in really good. And the reason I say mix it in really good is because I don't know if you can see this little baby, and nobody else probably will notice it except for me. But you see right here where there's just like that little red streak that goes down? That's where it wasn't. And it's not even red, it's the brown. Because remember, I ain't putting no red in there. I don't want to be a red bone. I'm high yellow. So it's a little streak of that brown. Now, it just looks like a striation or a variation of skin. But I know that it's a mistake I made because I didn't mix the color all the way. So see how people don't even notice the mistakes until you point it out? Y'all didn't even see that in the hand. Y'all ain't even give a damn about that. I saw it in the hand though, and I ain't like it. So there we go. So now that is what I want. I'm happy with that, because I know it's gonna look phenomenal as a hand. So now I'm gonna mix my part B. And so, like I said, I don't have to measure it because I already know it's equal parts, and I used exactly half yesterday of each of them, so it's going on to mix them. Making this is so much fun. The satisfaction that you get when you pull this hand out, y'all just don't even understand. Mothers will understand. Y'all gonna understand what I say when I say that it feels like you're giving birth without the pain. Wonderful. It's a great feeling. So there we go. No, I'm being cheap. I want all my, all of it, get in there. And yeah, it is gonna start to harden, but don't worry, you got like 15 minutes. So it's not like as soon as it touches one another, it starts to harden and stuff. You got like 15 minutes before it starts to harden. But we all know 15 minutes can fly by, except when you're trying to get off work. That's the only time 15 minutes don't fly by. Or when you're in traffic, 15 minutes seem like forever. When you're in traffic or when you're trying to go home from work, don't it? Okay, so this is nicely mixed. A little bit more brown. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. I'm gonna knock a pad. See how good? Now, that's what happened yesterday. You see how it makes like that striation right there? And I didn't mix it all the way in good because I was rushing. Because I was thinking, oh my God, I gotta get it done. I gotta get it done. Yeah. So, all right. So I said I'm about to pour her on in here. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm only gonna pour a little bit into the fingers. first. The reason is because I want to move this around a little bit just to make sure, because see, when I did my pose, my fingers are a little curved because I wanted them to be relaxed. And so I'll show you. And so I'm just moving this around in here just to make sure, number one, that all the air bubbles are out. Number two, it feels, you know, I'm tilting it in certain directions so that I can make sure that it fills all of the finger holes. Okay, so, I mean, I'm already scared about the fact that I might have been touching the sides of the, you know, or hollow ass fingers too. So here we go. We're gonna pour the rest of it in. We just made it. Oh my gosh. This is silly. Like, we just made it. So this is gonna be kind of a, not a shorthand. Not a shorthand, like, my palm is up here and still, yo, like, so maybe I used a little bit more yesterday. I don't know, it don't seem like it. It seemed like it was still more of it in there. See, that's a whole lot. I'm upset. But nope, not gonna focus on that. Because this hand is still gonna come out wonderful. And that's just that. So it's gonna be a little bit shorter than my other hand, but that's okay. I'm not really like tripping about that. I'm not gonna trip about that. That's what I'm gonna say. That's what I'm gonna say. I'm gonna say I'm not gonna trip about it. So what I'm doing right now, our air bubbles up out. All my air bubbles up to the top. But you see, she not all the way up to the top is right here. She right there. Like, so it's not like, it, like I feel like an ounce more and I would have had it, but that's all right. That's all right. I ain't gonna be upset because we get a hand, y'all. We gonna get us a hand up out of here. So I'm gonna come back when it's all dried up and we're going to demold her, okay? So I'll see you back here. And we're gonna give her 30 minutes. So it'll be about 30 minutes when I come back, okay? See you in a bit. All right, everybody, here we go. It has actually been about an hour because I kept messing with it. I was determined to get more in there because I wanted a sturdier hand. So, but yeah, so she's nice and firm. And so you can see all of the water, the moisture that comes from it. So when I said before, it's kind of like giving birth without the pain, you'll understand. I don't know if you can, we'll be able to hear the sound. I'm gonna try to put the phone down a little bit so you can see if you can hear that sound that comes out. So like I said, there's some suction. So, and no, you're not gonna get her out without destroying. So let's see. Did you hear that? There she goes. Ah, there's a hand. Oh my God. Look at her. And there we are, my right hand. Remember I told you that I thought that I was up against the pail? Doesn't seem like it. Oh goodness, well, here she is, yo. Hand number two. She's positioned, oh yes, my thumb is positioned a little better how I want it. She is great, so we're gonna clean her off. And then I'm gonna show you how we work that cuticle area, darling, so that we can put our press-ons in. But here you have it. I have my second hand. I'm sorry. Got my second hand. So we'll be back doing the cutes. Okay, everybody, we are back, and I'm gonna try to condition her a bit. As you can see the difference in between the two. This was the one that I did yesterday, and this was our baby that we just got out today. And the reason I call her a baby is because she's still all pink and shiny like a newborn baby. This one's been out for 24 hours. I haven't manipulated this one other than to put in to condition the cuticles, and that's when I first got her out, just like this one. But as you can see, she's settled down in her color and everything, and this one is not as sticky anymore. She is very sticky. She's fresh out of the oven, honey, just like a newborn baby. Ooh. But look at this detail. Do you see this? Look, every detail of the palm of my hand, okay? Fingers are perfect soft, and I thought that I was up against the container in there, and it would have been this finger. There's everything on this finger is perfect, nothing wrong. So yes, yeah. So here's what I'm gonna do to condition her a bit. I've got just a little bit of baby oil, so I'm gonna take a little bit of baby oil just a tad bit. I've already washed her off. And that, you know, water, that's not enough. It's just sticky. So, I'm gonna put her down for a second. I'm gonna go ahead, put some baby oil in my hands, rub together, and now we rub her. And instantly, she's not so dang sticky. I can handle her without my hands sticking to her. So, just like your skin needs some conditioning, some work, so does she. That immediately takes that sticky off for a second. Jesus. So she's a little bit easier to handle. You can practice your massage techniques this way too. Alright. Work that on into her for a minute. And then I've just got a little bit of contour powder here, just a little bit. And go on my darker side. And I'm just tapping. See how I'm just tapping? See how her color is coming on through? She's not sticky right there. I'm just tapping. I'm just dabbing, baby. I'm a dabber. For me right now, like I said, this is just getting some of that sticky off, honey. I need to be able to work with you. You're seeing the effects in the camera, but okay, making sure. That's so much better. Okay, she's still got a little bit of settling down to do, but this is gonna make it so we can work with her comfortably. All right, so now we're gonna work on the cuticles. I have an X-Acto blade. I have an X-Acto blade that I use. It's X-Acto blade number 11. And so, as you can see here, what I did, and I'll take the tip out. I've cut the cuticle areas, condition the cuticle areas so that a fake nail plate can be put on. And the way that I did that was that made a small incision right there up under the cuticle, made a little bit of a passageway there so that a nail tip can just stick on down into the cuticle area and go as far back as you need it to go to create the nail plate. So that's what, so now anything you want to do, if you want to do acrylic, if you want to do gel, anything, you can just, this, you know, the hand now has a nail bed, a nail plate rather, over the nail bed. And so you will just go ahead and you will glue your tip onto that or do your sculpting extension onto that, because the silicone hand, nothing is going to stick to this silicone hand, okay? So now it's time for us to condition our newbie. And so how I do that, I'm gonna wipe her off with a little bit of alcohol too, just on the fingertip area so that I'm able to see them doing, because I can't see right now what I'm doing. Need to dry her out a bit. About the fingertips. And dry you on out a bit. So I can see. You can see the indentations of exactly where the cuticle is and where the sidewalls are. And so that's what I'm gonna be cutting past. So the first thing is my blade is straight up and down because I'm just tracing the cuticle and the sidewall area. I see it and I'm just tracing it. Just following it. So, I don't know how well you can see, but I made that incision right there and I followed the sidewall cuticle and around the other. So now, it's gonna go through. The initial layering of that cuticle. What I'm doing, I'm just going back and forth very slowly with my blade. And it is hard to do this on camera where you can see. So I'm gonna have to come back, my darlings. Thank you. as you can see, the reservoir is not quite far enough back because this is how much of the nail left I need for the reservoir to be far enough so that you can push this whole nail in and have just free edge. So we have to deepen it a bit. This is the part right here, this part to pay for. Yeah, deepen that out a bit. So I'm gonna go back and I can see. I don't know how well you guys can see, but I can see what I'm doing. Through the finger itself. And so I'm almost back to that first knuckle joint. In the hand is where I'm going back to. I'm gonna do that on both sides. So let's see. That did it. It's just a regular number 5 tip. Let's see, boo. Let's see if that took you back far. Just about. And there she is, nail plate in. You know, now, it doesn't bother me. Like that happens, that doesn't bother me. I just know that's what's up. But nails are in. Nail is in to where I need it to go. So let's see if our others are as prepared.